Buried in the shadows of America's history books, an era known to its victims as America's Dirty War, a war against its own citizens. It's been 54 years since the FBI launched a covert war against political dissidents, the Counterintelligence Program, more infamously known by its acronym, COINTELPRO.
All the people don't have freedom, all the people don't have justice, and all the people don't have power, so that means none of us do.
The Black Panther Party, the American Indian Movement, anti-war organizations, even civil rights leaders and Hollywood stars. The list of targets was endless. Fueled by the frenzied paranoia of McCarthyism and the growth of radicalism, the objective of COINTELPRO was simple: undermine and destroy popular movements by any means.
Infiltration, destabilization.
The Brown Beret, we were victims of agent provocateurs, police infiltration. They tried to incite our members to go and commit acts of violence.
As the black nationalist movements gained traction nationwide, it also gained the FBI's attention.
They labeled the Black Panther Party as public enemy number one.
And the promising young leader Fred Hampton, a target.
When I leave, you can remember I said with the last words on my lips that I am a revolutionary.
Hampton was shot to death in his apartment. He was 21 years old.
If you take Fred Hampton, it was out and out murder. Direct murder. If they can't misdirect him, they just kill him. That's the rule. That's the history of the United States government.
American Indians are becoming militant, demanding the government take action to help solve their problems of poverty and discrimination.
At the site of the 1890 Wounded Knee Massacre, the American Indian movement held the government at gunpoint. The FBI moved in immediately. Dennis Banks was an AIM leader.
The suspicion was starting to rise after we realized what they were doing to the Black Panthers. And we had a series of meetings, the American Indian Movement did, saying, look, we've got to be aware that there's a great possibility that they might be, you know, targeting us for infiltration.
A reign of terror soon gripped the Pine Ridge Reservation in South Dakota. Over 60 AIM members were murdered. Others were dragged through the courts. Like Leonard Peltier, imprisoned for murdering two FBI agents, but some suggest the evidence and witnesses were flawed, corrupted. Today, to many, he's America's foremost political prisoner.
What we recognize now as political prisoners are people who came out of this era, who were the results of these attacks and who are still in prison. The United States government does not recognize having any political prisoners.
Before there were the WikiLeaks papers or the Pentagon papers, there were the COINTELPRO papers. In the late 1970s, activists broke into the FBI's field office in Pennsylvania, where they stole thousands of documents pertaining to the FBI's program. Almost immediately, a scandal exploded, and top officials from the FBI's National Bureau here in Washington, D.C., were summoned to Capitol Hill for a congressional investigation, which exposed the FBI's covert war against political dissidents in the United States.
The Church Committee concluded many of the techniques used would be intolerable in a democratic society today, even if all targets had been involved in violent activity. But COINTELPRO went far beyond that. The Bureau conducted a sophisticated vigilante operation aimed squarely at preventing the exercise of First Amendment rights of speech and association.
COINTELPRO was very dangerous for American society and even for the American judicial system to support that kind of raw terrorism.
A culture of surveillance, paranoia, and suspicion from the past that some argue has left American protest or dissident movements in disarray even today. Jahan Hafiz, RT, Washington, D.C.